Hello, this is Lucas Palmeira from Imaginando, and I'm here to give another tutorial on DRC. Today I'm going to show you how to make the background sound, the bass and main arpeggio for the song The Space in Between by Jan Blomqvist, remixed by Ben Böhmer. So let's get started with the background sound. It's kind of an arpeggiator that it's playing a little bit short metallic sound. So I'm going to start by having a DRC on a default patch. So let's bring it to the default patch. Okay, here we have it, and we start by raising the master and pregain to maximum, like this. And oscillator 1 at 807. Okay. We change the first oscillator to a square wave, and then we change the pulse width of the square wave to 0.150. Okay, like this. Now we go to the envelope generator 2 and drop it to 329. Cutoff frequency to 252. Okay, raise resonance to 146. Okay. And now we go to the noise, and we're just gonna raise the noise a little bit to 417. Barely hear it. Now, we go to the first envelope generator. This one modulates the amplitude, and we're gonna drop the decay to 274. Sustain, we're gonna drop it to zero, and release at 226. Okay, now envelope generator 2 that modulates the cutoff frequency in time. We have the decay at 136. Sustain at 310. And release at 489. Okay, finally we go to the modulation page. That this modulation page modulates the cutoff, and we're gonna raise the velocity a little bit to 209. This means that the higher the velocity, the higher the cutoff frequency. Okay, so now let's go for this to explain you all this processing. So first, the compressor is here. It's compressing a bit with high attack and short release. This means that I'm gonna basically boost the transient of the sound. The little, those 70 milliseconds won't be compressed, and after those 70 milliseconds the sound will fastly deep. So I have this kind of attack sound, really attacky sound. This delay on sync in 1/16, a little bit of feedback, a little bit of dry wet, ping pong connected, and some character. So I have this nice tape delay going on. Okay. Now, I have a delay, or a delay modulator afterwards with time, with very, very, very little time. Just 0.3. Very little feedback, low rate, medium depth, and medium dry wet. This is just to give a little bit of phasing to the sound and some stereo widthening to the sound apart from the delay. And next we have this equalizer that it's cutting the bass frequencies and boosting about 529 hertz, so it gets this little bit more metallic. Finally, a reverb to give it some room, just a little bit, and it's done. So let's now go to our bass and bring back this DRC to our default patch. Okay, just gonna turn the processing off for now. And we're gonna start by dropping one octave on the first oscillator. Do the same thing, put it on the same octave on the second oscillator. Then we go to the sub-oscillator and we raise one octave and change it from a sawtooth wave to a triangle wave, like this. And now we go to the amp section. So master at 0.765, pregain at 837, and now oscillator 1 and oscillator 2 at maximum, and now sub oscillator as well. Okay, it's really fat now. Now we go to the performance mode, so we can turn the portamento on. It's actually on, but the time is at zero, but we're gonna raise the time to 545, 445 milliseconds. Okay, 44. Perfect. Okay, now we go to the envelope generator 2 that controls the amount of envelope generator 2 modulating the cutoff, and we drop it to 0.263. Okay, bring the cutoff to 182. Okay. Now we go to the modulation page and we're gonna drop the keyboard to minus 150. This means that the lower the note, the higher, the lower the note, the higher the cutoff, since the keyboard, the value we're giving is negative. And for the velocity, we're gonna do the same and put it at 162. This means the higher the velocity, the lower the higher the velocity, the lower the cutoff frequency. Now we go to the VCA that controls the amplitude, and on the keyboard we're also gonna drop to -318. This means that the lower the keyboard, the higher the note. Okay. Finally, we go to the first envelope generator and decay at 0.5, sustain at 0.8, it's okay, release, it's perfect, at 0.3. Now we go to the second envelope generator and we raise the decay, sustain to maximum. And our patch is done. Now we go to the processing, and what we have here is a delay modulator, which is giving it a little bit of stereo widening, as you can hear. It's giving it quite a lot, actually. Then a compressor to control the sound. And we have our patch done. So let's go to our main arpeggiator and final sound. Gonna turn off the processing and I'll explain you later what everything is doing. I said this compressor before on the bass chord is basically, it's a sidechain compressor that is receiving the kick, so every time the kick plays in, it dips a little bit, the volume of the bass. So on the main arpeggio, let's now bring it back to default patch. Okay. And first thing we're going to do is raise the master to maximum, change the performance mode from poly to mono. Okay. Pre-gain at 884. Okay. Oscillator 1 at maximum. And now, envelope generator 2 at 0.347. 347. Cutoff at 0. Mode, change the mode of the filter from a low pass 4 pole to a low pass 2 pole. Okay, and now we go to the VCA, which controls the amplitude, and we're gonna raise the keyboard to 484. This means the higher the note, the higher the volume. And we're going to do the same for the velocity. This means the higher the velocity, the higher the volume. We bring it to 7, 2, 4, like this. Now we go to the first envelope generator and we drop the decay to 2, 7, 4. Okay. And the sustain, we bring it to 0. Okay. Now the release at 1, 7, 8. And now the envelope generator 2, which modulates the cutoff, we bring the release to 0, decay at 3, 4, 5. Okay, and the sustain at 501. Okay. Now, I'm going to turn the delay modulator, and this delay modulator has some time and low rate, high depth. This is basically to give it stereo widening, as you can hear. Okay, and this compressor is a sidechain compressor like the one before. And this compressor here is basically a compressor equalizing from 900 Hertz up. And this is because since I have loads of automations that you will hear in a second, when I open the filter, it means that I'm going to have an increase in higher frequencies and frequencies that are psychoacoustically more easy to hear. So if I compress just those frequencies, I can open the filter and still maintain the same kind of level or sensation of loudness when we're opening the filter. That's why I have it here. And finally, I have a little equalizer here to boost the high frequencies. Okay, so this is the sound. These are all the sounds. And as you can see, I have here some automations that you can afterwards check them out. Actually, you should, because they're important for everything that it's going on the synthesizer. So I think we can now hear it. So bear with me just a second while I put this ready for us to listen. Okay, I think it's ready.
Thank you.
this is it, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel. Give us a like. Press the subscribe button. We will have new content basically every week. So check us out. Goodbye.